We're at DIA in Munich, and one thing which is extremely essential is identity. Our digital identity needs to be easy and needs to be secure, needs to be wonderful, easy to use and cheap. And that at the moment is a big mess. But Signicat from Norway has been busy working on that problem. Anders, you're going to be the country manager for Signicat in Germany. How long did this company already exist?
About 10 years, or 10 years plus, 2007.
Yeah, because the Norwegians were very quick with their digital identification, right? The government did a good job in that. How many people work there?
Now it's about 100 plus, whereas 70 is in Norway, development, etc. Then we have 40 people outside in different countries.
Yeah. Okay, so you're really trying to conquer Europe and then from there and beyond. So what services does the company provide? Describe the steps.
First, we do KYC, first time registration of a customer. Yep. Second, we identify or authenticate them for the second or the returning journey. Yep. And we can also use that identity to do digital signatures, which also is a great achievement.
Yep. And you've conquered a whole bunch of the identification methods. The Dutch method, like EDIN and DigiD, are included. Which countries have strong digital identification at the moment?
We see Nordics, Baltics, Benelux, Germany is coming, Spain. Then we really started to get Italy and France up on the show there.
In 2019, the European community has said we need to accept each other's digital identities all over Europe, right?
Yeah.
Do you see that happen, or is that a fantastic opportunity for you?
Now we see it happen. For example, in Norway now, you should be able next year to log in for a government service with your EDIN ID in Norway, your Dutch ID.
Yeah.
And it's also driven by this PSD2 and GDPR. So yeah, there is a movement.
And it is extremely, if we want to be completely digital, we need to be sure that a limited amount of identity is available for that. Okay, so you're that one-stop shopping company. How many identifications do you do per month or per year at the moment?
Transactions-wise, we are now like 300 million transactions a year. But that doubles every year now, so it's going very, very fast.
Yeah. Okay, now I'm an insurance company. I want to basically make it very easy for me first to accept my own customers and identify them digitally because they are in my records, and then the second thing I want to do KYC. How difficult is it to set up with you? What to describe that process?
Technically it's about, we talk about hours, testing and user interfaces on the insurance company side might take a little longer depending on how clever they are with that one. But technically,
yeah, it's a service, easy to set up. You have to, and you're used to integrate with all kinds of incumbent companies and the IT systems they have there. Talking about pricing, give me a range of the pricing, how expensive it is for the first KYC, and then for the next time you want to log in.
Yeah, typically a first time is from 10 euro cents to one euro for a first time for a KYC.
Yep.
And then it's down to 0.1 euro cent to 1 euro cent for...
So it's extremely cheap and it doesn't really matter. You could do it all over Europe. But some of them, like EDIN, cost 50 cents KYC. So that comes on top of that if you use those kinds of identification. But you make it technologically very, very easy. Adia, what kind of customers are you looking for?
Now, we look for helping, especially the, we know that the insurance companies who's in the healthcare insurance, they desperately need strong identification.
Yep.
They're on the level of the BaFin and stuff we know from Germany, from the bank financing sector. So so that'll be the first priority. But our smart customers, they really don't use it just as a security element. They also use all the attributes that comes with the identity. So they can pre-fill forms, they can pre-fill contracts, they can start.
Digital signatures.
Digital signatures, of course, for the contracts or the agreements,
yep.
And also for the claims. And then we also see that that they can use external resources to sort of look up stuff using their AI engines, because we give them name, address, social security numbers, mobile numbers, emails, etc.
So, of course, companies which work over many, many, many countries, they are really interested to use something like yours, and otherwise they build it themselves, right?
Yeah, if you go do a one-to-one with EDIN, you might do it yourself. But if you want to do multi-methods, multi-countries, multi-applications,
yeah.
I have a good solution.
Sure.
And if you look at in Estonia, nobody signs anything on paper anymore, right? It's really extremely noisy. Is that the same in Norway? Does everybody sign with their PIN code?
Yeah, this is all about the Google second test called a toothbrush test, minimum use twice a day. And I use my bank ID minimum twice a day, so I always use that. That's my preferred, that's what I remember.
Yeah, that's
what you remember. That's actually what in my head. And if you see as sources of identity, of digital identity, you can have the banks, you can have the governments, and you can have LinkedIn or Facebook or other kind of weak, but extremely often used things. What do you see as trends? What is being used the most for what kind of purposes?
We see if you go into the regulated markets, which is bank, finance, and sometimes insurance, you have the healthcare. We have to go up on the highest level. But very often, you own
government.
Yeah, that's
those are normally government.
Government or banks, because they're regulated. Yeah. The other part is that we try to fetch the customers very often now on the social media, Snapchat. Young people, why do they need a bank? They have all other stuff. So we need to catch them in their channel, yeah. And then we upgrade. We ask for a mobile number, we ask for an email, we go out and look for other IDs that they have.
Driver license, passports, and that's all included?
Anything we can sort of then, but then we try to then find another level that's necessary or good enough for the service they want. Of course, if they want to borrow €1 million, they have to go to the highest level, or if they want a health insurance, they have to go to the highest level.
Extremely interesting field, and it's growing like rabbits, and it's very, very important that this is organized the right way. So, and the Norwegians are coming to Europe everywhere with their digital identity. Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh, and one thing, what did you think of DIA for you here?
DIA has been great for us. I mean, this is second time here, and we also attend Amsterdam, so for us this is a good one, both with existing and insured tech companies.
Thank you. Good luck.